Well, I decided to do it because I was relocating from Ireland back to my hometown of Swansea, having farmed, given up filmmaking for about 8 years. I wanted to do something big and juicy and Welsh, sort of and iconic. It was the centenary, the Dun and Thomas centenary coming up. Just felt the right thing to do. Do you want me to hold that? No, okay. Just felt the right thing to do at the right time. Be careful what you wish for, though. It's a very diverse, eclectic, big cast. I mean, they had to be first language Welsh, bar Charlotte and maybe one or two others, to cope with the back-to-back process of shooting it in Welsh and English. So, in a way, you sort of, you know, you feel a bit shackled, but it was the opposite for this, for me, because it just made the process so natural and quick, and it devoid of that jigsaw casting procrastinated nightmare that it can be sometimes, you know. There's a lot of good actors in Wales. I was happy hiring some, you know, sort of non-actors, inexperienced actors, I felt, that were right for this. And yeah. The period setting was, yeah, I mean, we didn't make it spot on 1951 or whatever. It was just sort of 50s-ish. Because it's a dreamscape, we felt we'd add license to kind of not be too tight on that. It felt, because it's written at a time and it's of a time, and the text, the poetic prose is of a time. We did think about maybe upgrading it to the 70s and contemporary, and it felt wrong. It just felt right to let it sit in that time. The erotica that kind of runs through the piece is there in the writing. It's not something I cottoned onto too much when I did it for O-level. It was on the curriculum when I was a kid. But yeah, I felt that having kind of attacked it again and looked at other productions, you know, over the years, it's never really alluded to the erotica that's just really in there. I mean, and not to have it, I think, would be doing the piece a disservice. And so I felt it was important to bring that out into the cinema.
How important was it having someone like Rhys Ifans involved?
Well, very important to have a marquee, you know, film name in your movie. I mean, independent films, is, you know, it's tough enough to shift a movie. Rhys and I had worked together on Twin Town. We've always stayed in touch, we've always been mates, we've speculated other projects. It just felt the obvious thing to do. I mean, and he jumped at it because it's an actor's magnet, you know, a Welsh actor's magnet anyway. And I think he's done a great job in terms of bringing the piece out of its RSC-ness. That I felt it was, you know, the previous, I mean, a fantastic rendition of Burton is of, again, it's of a time and it's of a generation and it's of a style. And although, you know, Burton was obviously Welsh, there's a kind of anglicised presence that I just wanted to bring it, Rhys to bring it back home to Wales. It's a Welsh piece of work.
What are you hoping that audiences, both those familiar and uninitiated in Dylan Thomas, take away from the film overall?
Well, I think, you know, Thomas has been kind of swept under the carpet for quite a long time. He's the most translated English language poet in the world, which is incredible, bar T.S. Eliot. He's an important poet. He's of a beat generation. He was a multifaceted writer. He was already speculating, working with the likes of Bunuel, musicians like Stravinsky. He would have ventured into all these other mediums. He was an animal for new stuff. And unfortunately, you know, he died young. But in terms of audiences, we've spent quite a long time this summer taking the film around arts festivals, counterculture audiences, Latitude Festival Number 6, Green Man, etc. So we found it was quite interesting to get a reaction from a different audience, like not just a one-dimensional film art house audience. We really feel this is sort of, in a way, more than a movie, and it's you know, Rhys describes it as sort of, what did he say? It's like watching an album. Is how he put it, and he's got a point, because it's an unusual experience, and so we're finding that we're connecting with a new audience now who actually don't necessarily know Under Milk Wood, don't know Dun and Thomas, and hopefully keeping the existing Dylan Thomas audience happy.